To see some concrete examples of interpolation, I've put together this little app. And it has two spinners here. The first one has a list of a bunch of different interpolators, like accelerate, decelerate, bounce, decelerate, linear, overshoot. And the second spinner has different timings from 100 milliseconds all the way up to 3000 milliseconds or 3 seconds, so that you can see how fast or how slow things work. So if we just select 3000 milliseconds, it's gonna be really slow. And just like Roman was saying in the previous video, it's kind of gratuitous to, you know, and it's just too much motion to be bouncing up and down that much. So let's try maybe a 900 milliseconds. That looks a little bit better. So let's switch to the code and see how this works. So here's the code that makes that work. We start off with creating a new instance of our interpolator. Because it's different based off of what the name is, we actually use the Java class for name to get the class and then instantiate a new instance. But if you were using this in your own app, you would call, say, new bounce interpolator directly. So after we have that, we call animate on our text view and set the interpolator and the duration from our spinner and tell it to start in 500 milliseconds and to move the animation from the bottom of the screen and then start. Check the instructor's notes for more information about interpolators or this sample app that you can play around with to see how they work a little bit better.